Hi everyone, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Mrs. R. Cynthia, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Processing, Preservation Technology, Faculty of Engineering, Avinash Lingam University for Women, Coimbatore. Introduction. Thermal sterilization of low acid food products, sometimes referred to as retorting. It has been widely accepted means of food preservation for many years. Retort pouch, which is a flexible pack, it has a material been developed as an alternative to metal can and glass bottles. It is a flexible laminated pouch which can withstand the thermal processing temperature of 120 to 130 degrees Celsius and combine advantage of metal can and plastic boil in bag. It provides superior barrier properties for a long shelf life, toughness and punctuating resistance. Low acid foods like such foods like pouches are normally used for packaging low acid products like meat, fish, vegetable and rice products. The retort pouch is a rectangular, flexible, laminated plastic, four-side hermetically sealed pouch in which food is thermally processed. It is a lightweight, high-quality, durable, convenient and shelf-stable packs. The material from which retort pouch are made are either aluminium foil bearing plastic laminates or foil free plastic laminate films. These must be inert, heat sealable, dimensionally stable and heat resistant to at least 121 degrees Celsius for typical process time. They should have low oxygen and water vapor permeability. Retort processing. After going through this session, you will be able to understand the thermal processing equipments, different methods of retort and its operations, effect of thermal processing and food quality. The thermal processing of packaged food product is generally carried out using specially designed equipment commonly called retorts, in which the packaged food can be heated under controlled condition at temperatures 110 to 135 degrees Celsius range, higher than the normal boiling point of water. The steam or water at high pressure needs to be used in order to maintain these operating conditions. The retort is often fabricated as a cylindrical shell. The most pressure stable shape is a sphere. However, spherically shaped vessels do not offer practically. The next best shape is cylinder, which is the one employed for most retort construction. The most important criteria for assuring an adequate process in a retort is the ability of the retort to maintain the designated temperature with good distribution on the heating medium to preclude non-uniformity. Uniform and constant temperature during retorting is vital for the success of the canning process. Temperature fluctuation during retorting can result in overcooking some products and underprocessing others. Because steam percentage in a steam or air medium depends on the retort temperature, this can also lead to changes in the composition of the steam or air heating medium. When the operation is based only on the steam, as for canned foods, either temperature or pressure can be used for process control. This is because there is a direct correspondence between the temperature and the pressure of the steam. At a certain pressure, saturated steam will have a definite temperature. The next is retort type. The retort can be of vertical or horizontal, both are common types. With vertical retort, mechanical hoists are used to move the crates of can in and out of the retort, whereas in horizontal retorts, they are moved on specially designed carts on wheels. Retort operation. A typical retort operation involves placing the can inside the cage or car, then moving the cage into the retort, closing the lid or door and securing all the bolts. Then steam is led into the retort with the appropriate set points on the controller. Initially, the drain valve is kept open to let the water from the condensing steam to remove from the retort. During the come-up period, the vent and all the bleeders are kept open. When the retort reaches a certain pre-selected temperature as indicated on the MIG thermometer, the vent is closed but the bleeders are kept open to keep the medium in some circulation. Process time is counted after the come-up. At the end of the process, the steam valve is closed and the water is let in for the cooling. When processing glass or flexible or semi-rigid containers, air is let into the retort to maintain the retort pressure at the same or at higher level. Without the step, the retort pressure could collapse very quickly due to the condensation of the steam upon contact with the cooling water introduced into the retort. Cooling operation with superimposed air pressure is called pressure cooling. In some situations, such as when processing retort pouches or other flexible or semi-rigid containers, air is also introduced during the heating process to prevent the tendency of gases present in the container to expand and interfere with the heat transfer. Such a processing operation is called overpressure processing. Pressure cooling would obviously follow a overpressure processing. Cooling is normally stopped when the cans are still slightly warm, so that when they are left exposed to air, can surfaces dry faster. This helps reduce the incidence of can corrosion. Sometimes the cans are fully cooled in the retort, while at other times they are transferred to cooling tanks after the initial cooling. Several observations are made prior to and during processing. Some typical information collected includes product or style of the pack, coat, scheduled process, retort and recorded number, the container size and appropriate number, actual initial temperature, the time steam on, when closing time and temperature, come up time, steam off time, actual processing time given and temperature on, MIG and recorded. The heating medium. Three heating media are used for thermal processing for achieving commercial sterilization: steam, water and steam or air. Steam is the best choice for the heat transfer point of view. Heat transfer from steam is mostly by condensation and convection. Surface heat transfer coefficient associated with condensing steam are in excess. Steam heated boiling water is a good choice, especially for glass containers. It provides good cushioning during heating and some tempering during cooling. Steam air media is a third choice. The heat transfer coefficient for water immersion heating media and steam air are somewhat comparable. They both can be enhanced by forced circulation of the heating medium by the use of a powerful pump or turbofans. With steam air, both pressure and temperature need to be controlled to assure a given concentration of the steam that determines the associated heat transfer coefficient. Generally, a steam concentration of about 75% is employed. The steam air medium offers a certain degree of overpressure during processing, which is a desirable feature for the processing of glass and flexible containers. With steam or air or water with air overpressure processing, retort temperature is controlled by controlling the steam pressure, and the air flow to the retort is collected by maintaining a total retort pressure at a calculated higher level. This is usually done by having a temperature controller and a pressure controller on the retort. The temperature set point on the controller determines the steam pressure, and the pressure set points determine the overall pressure. The overpressure processing. It refers to the processing of glass containers, flexible packages or semi-rigid plastic containers in the presence of an air overriding pressure above the nominal pressure of steam or water in the retort. It requires for maintaining the appropriate retort temperature. The temperature or steam at the prescribed pressure will be responsible for the retort temperature, and the extra pressure usually achieved by introducing the pressurized air, which will provide a counterbalancing overpressure to suppress the tendency of internal gases in the containers to expand during the processing, especially during cooling. It should be remembered that these containers, especially the plastic ones, are heat sealed, and the seals are generally very weak at the processing temperature. Even small fluctuation in the steam pressure during heating, especially when the internal temperature of packages are close to that of retort, can cause the internal pressure to exceed the retort pressure, thereby creating strain on the seals. Such processing condition will also allow the internal gases to expand and interfere with the heat transfer. The worst pressure differential between the package and the retort occurs at the beginning of cooling, when the admitted cold water collapses the steam in the retort and causes the retort pressure to quickly drop. When this happens, it causes a tremendous strain on the package seals. This pressure difference can cause the bottles to break or the packages to burst. The only way to prevent this is to provide a compensating air pressure that will prevail over the steam pressure, so that even when the steam collapses at the beginning of the cooling, the existing air pressure is large enough to counterbalance the container pressure. Hence, the presence of the air overpressure in the retort is extremely important to protect the package integrity during the processing. Both steam-air mixtures and water immersion heating can provide the condition for overpressure processing. The next is commercial retort. A retort might be accumulated for batch or continuous operation. Batch retorts are more familiar and are much more reasonably feasible. Continuous system offer higher speed, volume, energy savings and other services and are more costly. Some common types of commercial retort are explained below. Usually to reveal the certain type like steam, steam air or water immersion heating media, still versus agitation operation, batch versus continuous flow, or to express certain exclusive type of the heating medium or retort, such as a flame sterilizer, hydrostatic sterilizer or crateless retort. Another first is batch retort, steam retort. In the simplest version, it has one regulator for controlling the steam temperature or pressure. Other retort differences for operation with the water immersion as well as overpressure processing are also existing. They also provide a range of other canning accessories such as controllers, basket, can sealing equipment, blanchers, exhausters, peelers, etc. for small canning operation. These are stainless steel, steam water spray batch retort sterilizer that include overpressure steam sterilization with water sprays for higher temperature, short time cooking. Excellent temperature supply makes these retort suitable for processing tin plate or aluminium can, glass jars, plastic containers and pouches. Steam or air retort. Some retort apply the steam or air principle for operating performance. The following are features of the steam air retort. A fan forced steam or air circulation to achieve a uniform heat distribution throughout the retort. A ventless process resulting in significant energy saving and a cook room environment that is cooler and quieter. The precision control of cooling water temperature which minimizes the energy usage. The precise control of the steam or air process which results in a shortened cycle time for maximum production and consistent quality. Reduced process time and optimal heat transfer characteristics which allow foods to retain more of their natural qualities. In the steam or air retort, the steam is directly injected inside the retort chamber and are distributed. A ventilated fan generates a steam forced circulation and reinforces the temperature accuracy during the heat treatment. The opening of the steam inlet valve is automatically monitored depending on the program temperature parameters. The pressure is also independently controlled from the temperature by injecting or venting compressed air. During cooling, the condensate can possibly be circulated by a pump and sprayed on containers to be cooled. Direct mixing with fresh water or passing it through a heat exchanger cools this recycled amount of water. The water inlet in the cooling circuit or in the service side of the heat exchanger is automatically controlled depending on the programmed parameters. The integration of the heat exchanger in the cooling circuit allows the use of various water qualities without any risk of mixing with the process water that is in contact with packages. The pressure is always controlled in the same ways as during the coming up and holding steps. The next is water spray retort. In the water spray retort, a low amount of water is stored in the bottom of the retort and circulated by a pump with a high flow rate and sprayed on containers. The amount of water circulates through a heat exchanger where it is heated by steam. The opening of the steam inlet valve is in the heat exchanger is automatically monitored depending on the programmed temperature parameters. The condensates are automatically evacuated by a drainer and can be returned to the boiler. The pressure is also independently controlled from the temperature by injecting or venting compressed air. The same amount of water is then cooled through the heat exchanger. The inlet of the water in the service side of the heat exchanger is automatically monitored depending on the programmed parameters. The exchanger in the circuit allows the use of various water qualities without any risk of mixing with the process water that is in contact with containers. The pressure is always controlled in the same way as during the coming up and holding steps. Retort based on steam or air and rapid circulation of reheated water based on the water spray principle. A cascading water flow retort in which a powerful shower of water sprayed on the containers and the water is collected at the bottom is reheated and recirculated. By keeping a high flow rate, the temperature distribution in the retort is assured. The next is full water immersion. In full water immersion retort, a certain amount of preheated water at a preset temperature is stored in a tank on the retort. It damps the retort chamber and the circulator by a pump. This amount of water is steam heated. The opening of the steam inlet valve is automatically monitored depending on the programmed temperature parameters. The pressure is also independently controlled from the temperature by injecting or venting compressed air. For cooling, the water present in the retort passes through a heat exchanger where it is gradually cooled by a fresh water circulating in the service side. The water used for cooling can have various qualities without any risk of mixing with the process water that is in contact with packages. The pressure is always controlled in the same way as during the come up and holding steps. The next is crateless retort. The crateless retort system is designed for providing semi-continuous operation and some flexibility. System size and configuration are functions of the line speed, can size, cooking requirements and available space. The system is often configured to fit existing facilities. The system handles any process temperature up to 270 degree Fahrenheit and higher temperatures are also available. Typical application include processing of low acid vegetables, tomatoes, pet food, fish and meat products. In the first stage of process, the retort is filled with cushioned water. Cans are then loaded into the retort with high speed conveyor which accepts any size without modification. When the retort is fully loaded, the cushioned water is replaced by steam and the cans are cooked at the correct pressure and temperature. After cooking, the retort is once again filled with water and pressure cooling if necessary is performed. The cans are then gently discharged into the canal system for final cooling where temperature is constantly monitored. Cans then proceed along with the conveyor to the unscrambler to the orienter. All conveyor transfers takes place underwater. Automated microprocessor based control technology provides precise control of retort function and maintains critical record to satisfy the user's most stringent requirements. A water reservoir system, prefabricated piping, central motor control cabinet and a sand filter package are among the many options available. A series of retorts much larger in size are used. The advantage of such retorts are labor saving, steam saving and easy accommodation of various size of cans. Disadvantages include more expensive equipment and some damage might occur to cans during candling. The next is agitating retort. Certain products require agitating mode during sterilization. This can either be rotational or through a rocking action. The end over end rotation in retorts like rotary retort can create turbulence in products being sterilized, resulting in the greatest rate of heat penetration. In some cases, this can significantly reduce total processing time. Actual process time is subject to viscosity of the product and container headspace, size and configuration of the containers. Rotary retorts rely on rigid rotor design that will accommodate large basket size. Four-point bearings on the rotor ensure durability and make possible a two-door retort design. It is fully equipped with automatic door, pneumatic cage, and a cam down and the dedicated water shortage preheat vessel. Most are unavailable in either mild or stainless steel material of construction. Rotation of the product is achievable either continuously or discontinuously at speeds up to 30 rpm. Temperature and pressure can be ramped up and down and maintained within very tight tolerances. Next is continuous retort. Continuous retort in general more expensive but offer reduced labor cost, increased production rate, better heat transfer, better energy utilization. Another first one is hydrostatic sterilizer. The hydrostatic cooker is another variation of a continuous retort system that imparts mild agitation to a canned product. It is called as a hydrostatic sterilizer because the steam pressure inside the cooker is supported by water pressure. It contains of a feed leg, come up leg, sterilization chamber, come down leg and a cooling and discharge leg. The steam pressure in the sterilization chamber pushes the water down, resulting in a rise in the water level in the two legs. At equilibrium, the hydrostatic pressure in the water leg will be equal to the steam pressure in the sterilization chamber. The level of the water column in the water leg therefore determines the steam pressure in the sterilization chamber. Every 34 feet provides a pressure equivalent to 1 atmosphere. In effect, this would be equivalent to a steam pressure inside of about 250 degree Fahrenheit. The water level can be adjusted to get the desired temperature and overpressure if necessary. The cans are fed to the come-up leg from the feed leg through a conveyor chain that carries them throughout the process. In the water leg, the cans descend and progressively meet warmer water about 60 degree Fahrenheit at the surface to about 215 degree Fahrenheit at the bottom. The advantage of such a retort includes saving in the floor space, large reduction in steam and water loss, high capacity operation, compatibility with various size of cans and jars, precise temperature, less thermal shock for glass containers and mild agitation for containers. The obvious disadvantages are size and cost. The hydrostatic sterilizer provides continual process of almost all container size and types, including metal, glass and plastics. Next one is retort checks or process indicators. Low acid canned foods GMPs requires that food processors mark all retort basket, trucks, cars or crates containing unretort food product or some of the containers on the top of each basket with a heat sensitive indicator or by other effective means. Heat sensitive indicator are used to provide assurance that a retort load has not bypassed the retorting operation. Heat sensitive indicator are offered commercially in various forms including paint, lacquers, crayons, pellets, staples, labels and inks. Crayons, pellets, paints and lacquers change form or surface texture upon reaching a specific temperature. Some tapes and labels have an area that turn black upon reaching a certain temperature. That is accomplished by overlaying a thin sheet of black absorbent paper with a material of known melting point. When the melting point is reached, the cover sheet is absorbed into the paper so that the black indicating area can be seen. Other heat sensitive tapes are color coded and are available with stripes or other indicators that appear after the tape reaches a specific temperature. Except for the inks, all the indicators mentioned indicate only a specific temperature has been reached at the location of the indicator and do not relate to time. In contrast, chemical inks changes from one color to other indicating a particular time, temperature, steam condition that has occurred. Effect of thermal processing on food quality. The application of food processing technique that extends the availability of perishable foods also limits the availability of some of the essential nutrients. Maximizing nutrient retention during thermal processing has been a considerable change for the food industry in recent years. The major concern is the inevitable loss of heat-liable nutrient elements that are destroyed to some degree by heat. The extent of those depends on the nature of the thermal process. The major emphasis in food processing operation is to reduce these inevitable losses through the adoption of the proper time-temperature processing condition as well as the appropriate environmental condition in related to the specific food product and its target essential nutrient. Another, blanching. It perhaps represents the least heat severe of the above process. However, the nutrient loss during blanching can occur due to the reasons other than heat, such as leaching. Steam and hot water blanching are the two most commonly used blanching techniques. These conventional processes are simple and inexpensive but are also high energy intensive. It results in considerable leaching of soluble components and produces large quantity of effluent. Conventional water blanching has low capital cost and better energy efficiency than steam blanchers, and it results in larger losses of water soluble components including vitamin, mineral and sugars. It also results in larger volume of effluents and possesses a risk of contamination by thermophilic bacteria. With steam blanching, it is possible to significantly reduce the effluent volume as well as leaching losses if air cooling is adopted instead of water. However, uneven blanching can result if the food is blanched in multi-layer piles. The individual quick blanching technique is an innovation based on two-stage heat hold principle and has been shown to significantly improve nutrient retention. The next is pasteurization. The nutritional and sensory characteristics of most foods are again only slightly affected by the pasteurization process because of its mild heat treatment. However, it is only a temporary method of shelf life extension. The product quality continues to change during storage. The shelf life depends on the post-pasteurization packaging condition and storage environment. The most important non-acid liquid food is milk, which has received much attention as a result. Fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E, and K are relatively insensitive to heat, and generally there are no losses of these vitamins when milk is pasteurized. The extent of loss in thiamine, vitamin B6 and vitamin B12 and folic acid due to pasteurization is less than 10%. Vitamin C can be lost up to 25%. Let us summarize the whole thing. In this period, the retort process technology will have a very important responsibility to increase the Indian food industries because it gives the wholesome technology for the foods. By this, food can be used for longer time with safety hand. This type of retort products are safe to export and hence lead to the growth of economy. Thank you.